Hello friends, this is Dr. Pankaj Kumar, your mentor for Neat Bites. In today's sessions, we will be talking about the very first chapter of molecular biology, and that is the search of the genetic material. Right? You know, the story about the search of the genetic material way back in the year 1928. It was started with the experiment of Griffith. Okay. So there are two milestone experiments. One was done by Griffith, and second was Avery, MacLeod, and McCarthy. That was done in the year 1944. And later on in 1953, what happens that another experiment was done by Hersey and Chase, which finally conclusively proved that DNA is a genetic material, right? So today we will be talking about only the Griffith experiment, right? Now, first try to understand that what was Griffith experiment? Popularly, we call them transformation experiment, okay? Now, Griffith did his experiment with the two strain of bacteria, right? The one strain was the smooth form and the another strain was the rough form, okay? Now, what was the smooth form? The smooth form we are calling, why? Because there was a presence of the polysaccharides layer outside the bacteria. We know very well that bacteria has a cell wall, and outside the cell wall, there is a capsule, right? And that capsule is actually made up of polysaccharide. So that polysaccharides provides them the smooth things. And in fact, the smooth variety was a virulent one. They are responsible for causing the disease. On the other hand, if you talk about the rough form, in case of rough form, what we see that they are non-virulent or avirulent. So they are not capable of causing any disease. Okay. The bacteria was Diplococcus pneumoniae, right? And this bacteria is known for causing the disease, what we call pneumonia. Okay. So he did his experiment with mice and the strain of the different strain of the bacteria. Let's see what exactly he did, right? So first thing, what he did, he took a rough form of bacteria, right? And he injected in mice. So once he injected in mice, what happens? Mice died. And this death was due to the cause of the pneumonia. Because we know very well that the smooth form is responsible for causing the disease. Okay. In the second step, what he did, he injected the rough form. So when the rough form was injected, mouse survived. So again, it proved that the rough form is a non-virulent. It doesn't cause any diseases. Okay. And the third, what he did, he injected the heat-killed variety. Okay. So what is the heat-killed variety of S form? He took the S forms. He just warmed up, right? And then he injected that strain in the mice. You see, once you warm up, what will happen? That whatever the protein or the polysaccharide layer that is present outside the bacteria, that is going to be denatured. Okay. So that is why when it is injected, the mouse survived. Okay. But the big surprise came when he injected the rough form along with the heat killed form. Okay. Because you see, ideally, when he was using the two separately, then in both the cases, mouse were surviving, right? Initially, he used the heat-killed smooth form, the mouse survived. In case of rough form, also the mouse survived. But when he used both the things separately and he injected it, what happened? The mouse died. So that was a big, big surprise for him. Okay. Unfortunately, he could not explain the reason for this event, right? So, but he called them that it is a transformation. So once again, you can see, so this is the sum up. So you can see there that when we give the live rough form, then the mouse survived. When we give live smooth form, the mouse died. When we give a heat-killed smooth form, again mouse survived. But in case of heat-killed smooth form plus rough form, mouse died. As I told you, he could not explain the reason and the event was actually called as a transformation, right? So what was transformation? In the eyes of Griffith, he explained that the very conversion of the rough form into smooth form is actually called as a transformation. Because why the mouse died? Mouse died due to the form, due to the S forms. Okay, and there was no live S forms in the fourth experiment. So how this S form comes is this S forms comes after the conversion of the rough form into S form under the influence of what? The heat killed S form. Okay, so this event was actually called as a transformation. And as I told you that he could not explain the reason, and he simply concluded that this is a transformation. Later on, the reason was provided by every MacLeod and McCarty. Right? How the reason was provided, we will see in the next session. Catch me in the session to know about every MacLeod-McCarty experiment. Right? Thank you.